Ms. Pollamer had to leave, and so I'm using some of my time to read what she had to say. She wanted to speak about item A2 on the closed session agenda. The commission will deliberate to determine whether or not an officer-involved shooting was within policy. The involved party is listed as unknown, but some months ago, as a result of our advocacy, the president of the commission agreed to print the names of the involved parties so that the community would know which shooting was being deliberated. There was an officer-involved shooting that the community has been tracking, which occurred on July 25th, and it's reported in the agenda as July 26th. I recommend that if the individual in such a report cannot be identified, they are listed as unable to determine identity. The following are my comments. It is my understanding that the first two rows are specifically reserved for officers and that the community advocates cannot sit there. Yet, with seats open in those first two rows, officers were sitting in the rows behind, taking up spaces that we needed. Today, the cop to citizen ratio at the beginning of the meeting was one cop to every 2.5 citizens. After the recess, it was one cop to less than every 2 citizens. I don't understand why. Statistically speaking, we, the community, are more likely to be harmed by the cops and this board than the other way around. And since I've been coming to these meetings, I've heard a lot of talk about de-escalation. And I'm wondering if a group of 20 armed officers threatening a small group of peaceful, unarmed citizens with the infliction of pain, physical pain, is your idea of de-escalation. Earlier, when discussing houselessness, Cynthia said that we need to set aside our distrust, and that's laughable. Unfortunately, it's far more complicated than you just asking nicely. This department has repeatedly done things that diminish community trust. Izelle Ford, Brother Africa, Carlos O'Connell, Brandon Glynn, Riddell Jones, Alejandro Valencia. How can we just ask us to forget that?
Thank you.
Michael DeMoss, followed by Paula Miner,